According to Gottman Laboratory Studies, created by John Gottman, a professor of psychology, on the website American Psychological Association, PsychNet, in 2018, stated, "We have found that the success or failure of a marriage depends not on whether there is conflict, but rather how the conflict is handled when it occurs." Think about a time in the past week that each of us has had an argument with a person of the opposite sex. Chances are, it happens a lot. Men and women communicate differently through their nonverbal and verbal communication. Today, I will first be informing you on the ways men and women differ in their nonverbal communication, and secondly, on their verbal communication. To begin, let's discuss nonverbal communication. According to Amy Cuddy, a social psychologist on TED in June of 2012, her research found that women in the classroom setting tend to be less confident in their use of nonverbals. In the classroom, they'll shrink up and make themselves smaller. They won't raise their hand as high and don't ask questions. In the animal kingdom, they do the same thing. When an animal feels powerless or insecure, they will shrink up and make themselves smaller. But the opposite also occurs. When an animal feels powerful or in charge, they make themselves bigger. Men tend to do this more than women in the classroom. Men and women never mirror each other's nonverbals. We always compliment the other one. Men tend to be more confident in their use of body language in the classroom. They spread themselves out and raise their hand higher and ask more questions. According to Amy Cuddy, who I have previously cited, her research has also found that men and women use their smiles and how they feel, and that makes them different. Remember when I told you that women feel less confident in the classroom than men? This is important to remember, because if we smile more and spread ourselves out, even if we don't feel confident, it will create confidence that wasn't there. Men and women both try to do this, but for women, it works less than it does for men. Men and women also differ in their use of eye contact. According to Films for the Humanities and Sciences of psychological researchers, on the video, Men and Women Are Different, on the Infobase, on November 11th, 2012, their research found that women tend to use more eye contact than men and will listen to their speaker more often, while men use less eye contact, speak more, and don't often listen to their speakers. Now that I've told you some about the nonverbal differences in men and women, we'll move on to verbal differences. According to Films for the Humanities and Sciences, as cited previously, they have found that in an office or in a large group setting, women tend to interrupt less than men and don't ask questions or add in their ideas in the meetings. According to New York Open Center, a Minnesota psychologist on the video Men and Women Talking Together in 1993 found that women tend to be less direct when talking one-on-one with a man. For example, they might say, "Oh, it's cold out here," if they want the man to lend them their jacket. According to Films, as cited previously, men in meetings or in large group conversations tend to interrupt more and tend to lead the conversations more. They also will ask more questions and add in their ideas. But when being interrupted, they usually tend to talk over the interrupter, not allowing them to intrude. According to New York Open Center, as cited previously, men are more direct when talking one-on-one with a woman. For example, if they want the air conditioner turned up, they will either ask directly what they want, or they will do it themselves. To summarize, men and women communicate differently through their nonverbal communication and verbal communication. It's important that we know the different ways that men and women communicate so we can understand each other better. It depends not on whether there is conflict, but rather how the conflict is handled when it occurs. Remember when each of us remembered that time that we had that conflict with the opposite gender? Sometimes, whether it's nonverbal communication or verbal communication, all we need is human interaction. We are all here together.